हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू द केमिस्ट्री क्लास, ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट पोलार एंड नॉन पोलार कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड्स. कंटिन्यूइंग दैट, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डाइपोल मोमेंट एंड अप्लीकेशन ऑफ डाइपोल मोमेंट्स इन स्टडी ऑफ सिंपल मॉलिक्यूल्स. To study the reactions of any molecules, we have to know which type of the bond is present, what is the dipole moment, and how it is going to react. So, what is a dipole moment? A dipole moment is a quantity that describes two opposite charges separated by a distance. Or the product of magnitude of negative or positive charge and the distance between the centers of positive and negative charge is called dipole moment. For example, if two elements are there, and X and Y, they are bonded with one covalent bond. And if it is a polar bond, so one will get a slight positive charge, another will get a slight negative charge. So dipole moment is product of magnitude of negative or positive charge, whatever the charge developed on these atoms, the negative or positive charge, and the distance, that is bond length, this distance, bond length between the two centers of positive and negative charges is called dipole moment. It is usually denoted by mu. Mu is taken as symbol for dipole moment. So dipole moment is a vector quantity, that is, it has magnitude as well as direction. The molecule has dipole moment, then we call it polar. Let us see example carbon dioxide. So here the carbon bonded with two covalent bonds with oxygen, on another side also two covalent bond with oxygen. So in the last class, as we studied, the oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. So the electrons moving at this side, and here also electrons are moving at this side. So there is an equal and opposite forces present. So in carbon dioxide, equal dipoles in the bonds are in exactly opposite directions. So diagrammatically here shown, this is carbon, these two are oxygen, so there is an equal force on opposite side, opposite direction. So this is cancelled. So there is no any net dipole moment, because there is an equal moment and at the opposite direction. Therefore, its dipole moment becomes zero. So that this molecule is considered as non-polar. Dipole moment is a vector quantity and is represented by small arrow with a tail at the positive center and head pointing towards negative center. So already we have discussed, that is, a molecule, suppose XY, a molecule is there and it having one covalent bond, and Y is being more electronegative, X being less electronegative. So the bond is shown like this. Point. So the electrons are moving towards more electronegative atom. For example, here dipole moment of HCl molecule, H being less electronegative acquires a small positive charge. Cl becomes more Cl is more electronegative, so it acquires small negative charge. Therefore,
the dipole moment of this molecule is 1.03 dBi. So dBi is the unit that to measure the dipole moment. So HCl molecule can be represented like this. The arrow mark, the arrow is towards the more electronegative, and H being less electronegative, so the representation is like this. So what is the formula to measure the dipole moment? The degree of polarity is expressed in terms of dipole moment, that is mu, which is the product of charge and distance. Distance means the bond length present between the two centers, between two charged centers. It is expressed in dBi unit. So dipole moment mu or dBi is equal to charge into distance. So charge is measured in ESU, electronic systematic unit. Distance is in angstrom. So 1 dBi is equal to 10 raised to minus 18 ESU cm. So 10 raised to minus 10 ESU, that is E is equal to electron charge is 10 raised to minus 10 ESU, and distance is 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter, or we can convert it in angstrom. So this is the formula which is used to calculate the dipole moment. So let us see carbon tetrachloride. Again, the carbon tetrachloride, carbon at the center and 4Cl at the four corners of regular tetrahedron, 4Cl. And here the electrons are moving towards this Cl. Here also electrons are moving towards the Cl. So see here, equal and opposite movement is present. Resultant of these two dipole bonds is towards this side. Result of these two bonds is towards this side. Result of these two is towards this side. So again, it has no dipole moment because all the individual bond dipoles are cancelled, because it is equal and in opposite direction. Therefore, carbon tetrachloride having dipole moment zero. Again, the individual bond moment in that individual bond dipoles do not cancel in dichloromethane. Dichloromethane, carbon Cl, another one Cl, CH3 and CH3. Compared to CH3, Cl is more electronegative. So this is the electron movement from CH3. They are moving towards the carbon. So carbon is being more electronegative than CH3 group. But here Cl is more electronegative. So the resultant movement of electron is like this. So therefore, there is a resultant individual bond dipole is present. It is not cancelled like the carbon tetrachloride. So therefore, dipole moment for this dichloromethane is 1.62 dBi. Greater the negativity difference between the bonded atoms, greater if the dipole moment. Greater is the dipole moment. The dipole moment of hydrogen halides are in the order. Suppose the bond between hydrogen and fluorine, hydrogen and chlorine, hydrogen and bromine, hydrogen and iodine are compared. The electronegativity of fluorine is more than chlorine. Chlorine is more than bromine. Bromine is more than iodine. Therefore, dipole moment of hydrogen fluoride is highest and dipole moment of hydrogen iodide is least. So here some polar and non-polar bonds along with their dipole moments are given. So if there is a resultant dipole is there, then it becomes a polar and it having some dipole moment. If all the dipole moments, if they are equal and they are in opposite direction, then they are cancelled and dipole moment becomes zero. Let us see still more examples. So for symmetrical molecules, dipole moment is zero. But for asymmetrical molecules like HCl, HBr, HF, they have some dipole moment. If molecule contains two or more polar bonds, its dipole moment is obtained by vectorial addition of dipole moments of concerned constituent atoms. So let us see the examples. Carbon tetrachloride, already we have seen that is a symmetrical molecule. So the dipole moment is equal and in opposite direction. Therefore, it cancels. So net dipole moment is zero. In the bromine tetrafluoride also, the net dipole moment cancels. Therefore, dipole moment is equal to zero. In methane molecule, CH, so all the four, therefore all the four bonds, the dipole moment is equal and in opposite direction, therefore it is zero. So these becomes non-polar molecules. Asymmetrical molecules means for water molecules, oxygen, hydrogen. Hydrogen is less electronegative plus, and oxygen is more electronegative minus slash, little minus charge. And the electrons are moving towards the oxygen. Here also electrons are moving towards the oxygen. So net movement of electron is like this. So this is a resultant dipole moment. Therefore, water has dipole moment 1.84 d/. Like that, ammonia molecule having dipole moment 1.46 d/. Hydrogen fluoride, it having 91 d/. So it is highest in all the hydrogen halogen bonds, that is hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide, hydrogen iodide. Compared to all these, the hydrogen fluoride having highest dipole moment. In the chloromethane, these three, the for three hydrogens, the electrons are moving towards the carbon, but the net dipole moment is like this. So it having a dipole moment 1.86 d/. Nitrogen fluoride is also having resultant dipole moment. So mu dipole moment is equal to 0.24 d/. So what are the applications of this dipole moment? So in determining the polarity of bonds, greater the magnitude of dipole moment, higher will be polarity of the bond. In determination of symmetry of molecules, if any molecule possesses two or more polar bonds, it will not be symmetrical. If it possesses some molecular dipole moment, if it possesses some molecular dipole moment, then the molecule is non-symmetric. If the net dipole moment is zero, then the molecule is symmetrical. So like that, to identify, to determine the polarity of bonds, to determining symmetry of the molecules, dipole moment is used. If the molecule contains a number of similar atoms, like linked to the central atom, and the overall dipole moment of the molecule is found to be zero, this will simply says that, imply that molecule is symmetrical. So already we have seen these examples that molecule becomes symmetrical. So by measuring the dipole moment, we can distinguish between cis and trans isomers. So cis isomers usually has a higher dipole moment than the trans isomers, because in the trans isomers, suppose for example carbon, double bond carbon, and these are trans, and suppose cis is present, then both the same similar groups are at the one side. For example, this is X and X, Y and Y, but in the cis form, X and X one side and Y one side. So there is a repulsion, and due to that, cis isomer usually has a higher dipole moment and trans isomer has less dipole moment, because the dipole moment is opposite and equal. So here it is not opposite, exactly opposite. So therefore, trans isomer having less dipole moment, cis isomer having more dipole moment. So distinguish between ortho, meta and para positions, dipole moment is used. So what we learned in this video, molecular dipole depends on the geometry of the molecule. When the molecule does not possesses a net dipole moment, the molecule is nonpolar. When the molecule possesses a net dipole moment, the molecule is polar. So in the next class, we'll go for the actual mechanism, that how the bond cleavage takes place and the reactions takes place. Thank you.